This is a trip from London to Hamburg in Germany. And you can see the bus is loaded and they're about to keep moving. This is a very wonderful journey starting from 6 p.m. It's 6 p.m. in London and we're advancing quietly, moving towards the highway. By the time we get to the highway, by then it would have been dark. And you see how it is. You can see the bus conductor taking a note of all the people in the bus, and everybody seated quietly, peacefully, and the bus is about to move. And when it moves, you see the highway. The highway is wonderful. Everywhere is lit. I mean, there are reflectors on the highway. We don't have any cops for alarm. Look at the highway. It's a very wonderful one. This is where we are going to move from Victoria City in London to Hamburg. Hamburg City. Just sit back and enjoy yourself. Thank you.
My name is Alex. Alex.
Okay, you are the one who drove us. You drive very well. You are a good driver.
Thank you very much.
All right, thank you. What a long journey. What a long journey. You know, traveling in the night, could be fun. But a lot of Nigerians don't think so. They believe that traveling in the night is risky and very, very dangerous. I mean, it's a risky affair, you know now. If you have ever traveled in the night in Nigeria, you would understand what I'm trying to say. It's very, very risky. I mean, the road is, so dark and bad. You know, some of these buses, if you are in front of the bus and you're looking into the highway while you're traveling at night in Nigeria, it will look as if you're plunging into darkness. Woe betide you if the car you're traveling in doesn't have good lights. It's terrible. Sometimes you see fallen containers on the road. But it's just a different thing from what we saw right now. I'm just coming from London, from Victoria bus station, London, to Hamburg. So this is the central bus station in Hamburg. Like you all saw in the bus, there was nothing like attachment. The bus was free. People relaxed. Some of the people were even reading books. Nobody was afraid. Everybody was relaxed because there is nothing to fear. You understand? There are no armed robbers on the road. The road is not bad. So people just traveled, and it's the best time to travel in the night because it is cool. The hot sun is not there. It is cool, and there are less vehicles on the road at that time. But I know a lot of people don't believe me that traveling in the night. Some people will say that traveling in the night is risky. That if you're traveling in the night, when you're traveling in the night, people will be praying for you. They will hold night vigil for you to get home safely when you're traveling in Nigeria. But like we have already seen, it's different here. This is Zob, the central bus station in Hamburg. From here, you can buy a ticket to Amsterdam, to France, to London, Denmark, Holland, just name it. Like I told you, traveling in the night can be wonderful. It's fun in Europe. When you're traveling in the night, it's fun. You know, unlike some other places in Africa, when you're traveling in the night, you have your heart in your mouth. You are afraid of armed robbers and a lot of things, a lot of circumstances that will make people to be afraid. But here in Europe, it's different. I have a very beautiful sister here today. And can I meet you? What's your name?
I'm Vaida Ade from Ghana.
Vaida from Ghana.
Yeah.
And Vaida, are you traveling tonight?
Yes.
Where are you traveling to?
I'm traveling to Paris.
How often do you travel? How often do you travel in the night?
Oh, you know, I love traveling in the night, even myself. I drive myself to London, to Paris, but this time I'm just from Africa. I came yesterday from Africa, so I'm so tired. That's why I want to go with the bus. But it's so fun to travel at night here, because the road is cold and you won't meet any car, so it's so nice to travel in Europe.
Can you compare traveling in the night in Europe and that of Africa?
Oh my God, in Africa it's terrible, because I just came from Ghana, and since I love traveling in the night, so I thought maybe in Ghana I can do so. I nearly had an accident, and what happened in night, you know, there a lot of things can happen to you. Like, it's not safe, not even safe on the car side, but you can meet the armed robbers, but here it's very safe. I travel alone to London myself. So
in the night?
In the night. The whole night. I just love travel.
And you drive yourself to London in the night?
London, yeah.
Wow.
If not, then I go with my son. Just like that at night. Because the next morning I have to be there. So just love to travel.
Do you have any advice for our leaders in Africa concerning our roads and traveling in the night?
I think if I want to say something, then safety first, because since we are not safe over there, so you can't even go at night. And secondly, our road is so bad that even if it's rain, you can't even see anything. So I would love to advise my leaders if they can do the roads for us, and so that we can go out at night.
Thank you very much. It's my pleasure talking to you, and I wish you a safe trip to Paris tonight.
Thank you very much.
All right, thank you. As you can see, the whole place is quiet and organized. Nobody is trying to snatch your bag. Nobody wants to snatch your bag to push you into a bus. Rather, you come, you make up your mind which company you want to travel with. Then you go and buy your ticket quietly. After buying your ticket, you look at the plan and know the time the bus is going to move. Then you sit quietly, either you're reading your magazine or you're just listening to music or whatever. But the most important thing is that it is peaceful out here. No touting. Even the bus drivers look like bankers. They wear tie and they are smart. These are drivers. You see those two guys? They look like bankers, but no, they are bus drivers. And yes, lest I forget, each bus have two drivers, one driver and an assistant driver. Do you know why? Because while we are traveling in the night here in Europe, each driver is entitled to drive only 4 hours. You cannot drive more than 4 hours. If you drive more than 4 hours and they have a police check, a police control, that means you're going to pay a fine of 2,500 euros. So it is very, very important. This is put in place for the safety of the people, because when a driver drives for a long time, he becomes drowsy. He can fall asleep and it can cause accident. Okay, so that is why it is very, very important for a driver to drive for only 4 hours, then it will change to another driver, just for the safety of the people, to tell you that the government or whoever put whatever in place have the safety of the people in mind. Yeah, I would like us down home to emulate the safety measures so that it shall be well with us. Thank you.